You might have seen Home Assistant's built-in motion-activated lights blueprint, which is great, but I find it to be a bit lacking in functionality, especially if you only want your lights to automatically turn on and off when it's dark. I've tweaked that blueprint to give it a bit more flexibility. The built-in motion-activated light blueprint is functional but very basic. You can choose your motion sensor, pick the lights it will be targeting, and how long after motion has stopped that the lights will be turned off. It works reliably but does have some shortfalls. What if you have multiple motion sensors in a room? You'd need to group them together first as a template binary sensor before you can use them. And if you only wanted the lights to turn on when it's dark, then you'd again have to create a template motion sensor that only triggers when it's dark. It's all a bit complicated, so I set about adapting the blueprint to my own requirements. Start by copying and pasting my blueprint YAML code from my website, the link will be in the description. Save it to a file called motionlightlux.yaml. Then upload the file to your blueprints automations folder. I'm using the file editor add-on for simplicity here. Just navigate to the blueprints folder and automation. Click on the upload file button, choose your file and click on OK. Now you need to reload your automations by clicking on Developer Tools, scrolling down to Automations underneath YAML Configuration Reloading, and clicking on the link. Now, these automations need a lux reading or illuminance level, and to get a lux reading, you need a lux sensor. There are a number of options out there, but I have a couple of suggestions that I use regularly. The first one is this Fibaro eyeball style multi-sensor. This is the Z-Wave version, but they also sell a HomeKit version too. It's a motion sensor, temperature sensor, lux sensor, and even has accelerometers inside which can detect earthquakes. It's pretty cool, but it's also pretty expensive. If you're going to make use of all these sensors, then it's a good one to go for to save you having lots of devices stuck around your house. The second one I use is this little Show Me Zigbee light sensor. It's permanently stuck to the inside of a south-facing window in my house, as you can see here, and has been running off the same CR2032 battery that it came with for about 2 years now. These things are brilliant, and they only cost about a tenner. I don't know how accurate they are, but that doesn't actually matter. They just need to be consistent, so a lux value of 1000 on one day is the same brightness as 1000 lux the next day. Anyway, once you've got your lux sensor working with Home Assistant, you're ready to create your automation. Click on Settings, Automations and Scenes, and the blue Create Automation button. Choose Motion Activated Light with Lux Sensor from the User Blueprint drop-down box. Give it a name, and then you need to choose your motion sensor. You'll notice that when I select this motion sensor, another empty box appears. You can add multiple motion sensors to this blueprint if you want. Then choose your light. You'll notice again, you can choose multiple lights if you want to. Now you need to choose your manual override switch. I've mentioned this before, this is a kill switch that disables all of your automations if you enable it. It's good practice to do this, so if you haven't done so already, go and create yourself a toggle helper for this. Then you choose your lux sensor and select the light level required for the automation to run. It's important to remember that the automation will only run when the light level drops below this value. So if you want to test it during the day, set this quite high, but you'll need to look at historical data from your sensor to know the best value to set this to in your specific situation. Lastly, there's the wait time. This is the delay in seconds for the lights to stay on after the motion sensors have stopped detecting motion. In high traffic areas, this can probably be set quite low, but if you're using this in places like a kitchen or dining room where people could be sitting still for long periods of time, you want to set this to quite a long time period. Click on Save, and then click on your Automations tab again, and you should see the automation appear. As I said, getting that lux level right for you is a tricky process. My Show Me sensor, the one pointing outside, is actually used by most of my automations so as they know if it's dark or not. It'll even kick in during the daytime if the weather is particularly bad and it gets dark because of the clouds, which is pretty handy. Anyway, I'll put the blueprint configuration up on my website for you to use, and links to that along with the details of all the sensors I've used down in the video description. I hope this has been useful for you, and if it has, then please give this video a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.